All of you for joining us tonight. This is our first indoor concert in 21 months. The last time we had a concert, am I right about this? The last time we had a concert was March 13th.
No, it was March 11th.
March 11th, so it very quickly reminded me that I was wrong. Was it, what day was it?
Wednesday.
It was Wednesday, the day before everything shut down.
We were done.
So, I hope history doesn't repeat itself. To be honest, I'm a little nervous standing up here introducing this concert because 21 months ago it was the beginning of this, which leads in perfectly to me thanking you for wearing a mask indoors. I know it's not convenient for everybody, but it is a state mandate, so I appreciate everybody complying. I want to thank our wonderful music teachers, Mrs. Foster, Ms. Evans, and Mrs. Allmeter, and Ms. Sweet. And yep, round of applause, please. It's amazing. Throughout all of this, for the last 21 months, they have gone above and beyond to prioritize our students and their love of music. It's been amazing to see through everything that we've been through, and it's been great to see everybody back together again and hearing the noise coming from the cafeterias, Bells 3, and definitely Bells 9 with these guys. So proud of them, and it is amazing to see everybody dressed up. And I can't wait to hear the concert. So I'm going to be brief. I know I hear Mrs. Foster has some things to say, so I don't want to take up all the time. So thank you all again for joining us this evening. I enjoyed the show, and I will turn it over to Mrs. Allmeter.
Thank you very much, and just to echo Mr. Kapani's thoughts, we are very, very happy to be here with you performing live inside. We do have inside the front cover of your program are just our district-wide expectations as they align with concerts. So they are in keeping with our school-wide expectations for all things, so please make sure you take a look at that. You'll notice a couple things just a little different tonight because this is the first time that almost all of our students have been in this space, that as each group starts, we will need to take a little bit of time to do a little bit of warming up in this space because they've never sung in this space or played in this space before. So normally we would not do those warm-ups out here, but we will need to do that a little bit this evening as well. So we thank you so much for coming and for making this happen and for sharing your wonderful students with us. We have a special treat this evening in honor of all we have been through and what is most important to us as musicians, as educators, as students. Our eighth grade band is going to start us off with something special. So again, thank you very much for being here, and eighth grade band, take it away.
Good evening. I decided I needed to introduce myself because I don't think I've met many of you in person, except for I know that there's a few of my old students sitting in the audience. My name's Carrie Foster. I was at Valmy for 25 years, and then I moved over to the junior high. This is my sixth year here. I had the joy of having all of these lovely students last year, but in little tiny groups. And before that, we were meeting online, and I was seeing their little face in this little tiny square. And it was terrible. But like Mr. Capone said, the last time that we stood in here for a concert, the current freshmen were seventh graders. It was my birthday. And we had no idea it would be the last time that we would play together for 2 years. So I get up here on stage, and we do our business as quick as we can, and we get off. But I thought, we're not up here again for another 2 years. We're going to monopolize your time. So we're going to read a story for you today. I ran across this book, and it is so pertinent to what we are doing here today. It's so glad to be back together. Wait till you hear them all. I was telling them the last time you heard these guys play is in their sixth grade December concert. And I know the Valmy kids didn't have one because it got snowed out. So the last time you heard these guys play as a group, it was in sixth grade in December. I hope you see a large improvement. But here we go. This story, and the pictures are going to be up on the screens on the side. You couldn't put it in the middle because it would have ran into us, is Together.
Life can seem like a machine in constant motion. There's no time to stop. The clock is ticking and there's always somewhere you need to be.
even when we're too busy to think, our daily rhythm sweep us along.
We can rush through our days without seeing them.
But I remember the storm that your music building scraping amongst us.
Crowns began to wander.
Dark clouds were looming in the distance. We watched them gather and we wondered.
When will it come? How long will it last? It's hard not having all the answers.
And at once everything stopped, lights and engine ground to a halt. We could feel the weight of the dark sky overhead. Streets were suddenly deserted.
Quiet. Where once there was an orchestra of noise, the busiest of places stood empty and still.
Normal things began to go strange, strange things began to go normal.
Fear can be a funny thing. It doesn't always shine in a flat of light.
It can make us forget that others are scared too.
We took shelter knowing the worst was yet to come.
Weeks went by, it rained and rained, it felt like it would never end.
Heroes among us stepped forward. They held us together and put others first.
They were battling the storm in ways we could not even imagine. We were humbled by the courage. They deserved our applause and so much more.
It's hard to be separated. Furious can seem to overflow. We felt so apart.
We began to understand the distances that had between us already, and that loneliness can beat its drum the loudest and
but being alone doesn't have to feel lonely.
When life became smaller, we found space to see the bigger picture.
Perhaps we were more similar than we had thought.
We were united by our separation. We were together and being apart. We talked, we listened, we shared our sadness, grief, and worry. We shared our stories and experiences.
Hard times can help us find the best that we can be.
Little things can mean a lot.
Some of us found we had more time. Time possessed us with ideas to plant, like seeds, and the patience to nurture them and watch them grow.
We found new ways to keep in touch.
Our homes became dance halls, classrooms, and bakeries.
We slowed down and woke up to the most important things that we know.
We began to understand that the sun was still there, rising, setting, waiting, even when the clouds were at their darkest.
We marveled at nature and drew comfort from trees that hadn't weathered the storms for decades and still stood strong. Their endurance reassured us.
In a time of uncertainty, we found comfort in the seasons.
The moon, the stars, and the birds in the trees washed over us.
In stepping back, we had left the path clear for nature to step forward.
And when slowly the rain and winds began to subside, when clouds became lighter, and at long last sunlight fluttered through.
A new calm emerged.
We value our connections, we share a kinder perspective.
And now.
We look, we hope, to the future. Though clouds may gather again, and we may see other storms, we have to realize, most of all, that we are stronger facing them.
Together. The first piece we're going to be playing is To a New Beginning by James Swearingen. The uplifting feeling of this title comes through beautifully in the music, which has a very appealing folk song-like quality. We selected this piece because we were ready for a new beginning after our absence of playing together. This piece helped us play together as a group again. This advanced music has many instrument sections playing individually. Listen for the many conversations that occur throughout the group between sections.
No.
Water.
Really clean.
Exciting journey as we ride around to the record.
We had many challenges putting this piece together with a lot of independent rhythmic counting to dynamics to articulations. Please sit back and enjoy the ride.
Musicians.
Before we end tonight, this is their favorite piece, even though I told them that the train piece would be your favorite piece. I would be amiss if I did not recognize, we have about 6 or 7 students out quarantining, and I feel so bad because we worked so hard for this concert that they're missing this. I hope they're watching at home, and I hope they're able to be on stage with us sometime.
Hey, good to hear you.
Good.
There we go.
And I realize many of you know me and you know that I like to talk, and I realize that live we don't, and that I never introduce myself at the beginning. My name is Stephanie Almeter, and I am our music facilitator for the district, and I'm also one of our chorus teachers and the general music teacher at the junior high. So you will see me conducting tomorrow night if you're here with seventh grade, and today you'll see me behind the piano and in a supporting role with our fabulous eighth grade chorus. And with our newest addition, Mrs. Sweet is not new to our district. She teaches at Lanigan, and she this year is also coming to the junior high and working with our eighth grade chorus. So we support each other and we loop with our groups. It's a wonderful partnership, so we're thrilled to have her with us. So Jody Sweet, welcome. Eighth grade chorus, welcome. Here we are. You'll notice, as I said at the beginning, that we're going to do a couple of little warm-ups. This is the first time they've ever sung in this space. So the first couple things you hear will not be our full-on concert pieces, but just giving us a chance to hear what we sound like in the space. So thank you again. I'm Stephanie Almeter, and this is Jody Sweet.
Thank you. music teacher, Mrs. Ballmeter. She's going to be playing piano for us during this. And I just want to say it's been a pleasure working with her, and she is just as much a part of this group as anybody. So, you'll see Mrs. Ballmeter.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.